Everything started when my niece Jackie called me. She said the police had finally located her parents' bodies. They had been missing for 20 years. I went to the police station to support her.
Here we are, miss.
Auntie, can you believe they actually found them? Maybe I can finally get some closure. Let's go. The sheriff's waiting for us.
Miss Gray, it's nice to finally meet you. As Jackie told you, we've located the remains of Alexander and Natalia Gray. We can now prove they were victims of Greg Duffy, a serial killer who was active here at that time. This is everything I've gathered about the case. Take a look.
Alexander and Natalia Gray went missing on April 23rd, about 20 years ago now. They're survived by their daughter Jackie. The Gray's car was found in the woods close to town. Four teenage witnesses were camping nearby when they heard a car followed by a woman screaming. The Gray's tires were punctured by a spike strip found nearby. We also found tire tracks near their car, likely from a large truck. We believe the killer's vehicle made these. These circumstances perfectly match the other victims of the roadside killer, including the fact that there was no gun or any other weapon found at the scene. We also have camera footage showing a man who fit the killer's description. He was driving a truck. Thankfully, Jackie was staying with family at the time of the incident. The killer always targets his victims randomly. We got a clear picture of the killer, thanks to a recording taken at a gas station in town that night. We quickly identified the suspect as Greg Duffy, who lived in a small house in the woods and sent a squad to apprehend him. What we found there haunts me to this day. Duffy was obsessed with hunting, and his weapon of choice was a hunting knife. But Duffy hunted people, not deer. He used his spike strip like a bear trap, snaring out-of-towners along that remote highway. Unfortunately, Duffy wasn't at home. To this day, the roadside killer has never been caught. This is the only photo we have of him.
I heard about your gift, Miss Gray. Can you really travel to the past just by touching an item from that time? These car keys were found with the remains. We believe they may have belonged to the Grays.
My parents didn't deserve to die, Auntie. If you can, please save them.
That spike strip, and now their tires are flat. There's a truck approaching in the distance. Could it belong to the roadside killer? The case file mentioned teenage witnesses who were camping nearby. That's probably their campsite ahead. Maybe they have a vehicle I can use to reach town.
Thank you. Thank you. It is their destiny to die.
I could crash that squad car into Greg's truck. Then the police will catch him for sure. I should be able to find new tires for their car in there.
I am Atropos, the fate who severs the threads of human life. The Greys were destined to die in that plane crash, but they escaped. The Greys must die. Meddle not in the affairs of fate, mortal. Return from whence you came.
Jackie, I did it! I saved your parents from Greg Duffy!
Greg Duffy? What are you talking about?
Never mind. Where are your parents?
Auntie, are you feeling okay? They died in a fire 20 years ago. That's why I'm here, Auntie. I want them to reopen the case. That fire wasn't an accident.
Miss Gray, these are the materials recovered from the Gray house after the fire. Perhaps you'll find one that will help you visit the past.
Auntie, please, go to the past and save my parents.
April 23rd. Investigation of the fire at the Gray's house. Two victims, Alexander and Natalia Gray were in their house on Franklin Street at the time of the fire. Due to another fire raging in the city, the fire engine was late arriving to the scene. The Grays are survived by their young daughter, Jackie Gray. Her aunt and uncle, Louisa and John Gray, are going to adopt her. She's in good hands. Poor kid. Our preliminary examination indicates the fire started in the kitchen, likely due to an electrical malfunction. Witnesses claim they couldn't enter the apartment because the doors and windows were jammed shut, almost like someone was holding them closed. We're considering the possibility this is an act of arson. If so, it's clear the attacker intended to burn down the whole house, killing its occupants. New evidence has come to light that disproves the arson theory. Our expert electrician said rats chewed through the basement. It's strange. The Grays barely missed a deadly plane crash 2 years ago, but now it's like death caught up to them.
Darren, are you done playing with your new recorder? Come on, we couldn't find anything else. Let's call it a night, all right?
Fine, just let me finish. In conclusion, the evidence we collected indicates an accidental fire due to faulty wiring. And, well, I guess this case is closed.
Jackie's parents are busy doing their daily routine. I need to find what caused the fire.
They were destined to die on that plane. You cannot change their fate.
It's little Jackie. She must have survived because she was playing in the yard.
Jackie. This time, for sure, I'll save your parents.
You are quite persistent, Miss Gray, but if you defy me, you will only hurt the ones you love. Now, sink into oblivion. You again? How many times must you tempt fate herself?
That's odd. I'm back at the police station. Jackie, why are we here?
It's about my parents. They died on April 23rd, 18 years ago.
Their deaths moved back a year again. Instead of trying to prevent their future deaths, maybe I should focus on the plane crash that caused everything. Jackie, do you have anything from the plane crash that your parents survived?
Sure. It's all here on the desk, Auntie.
It was April. My parents were leaving on a business trip, so I was staying with Aunt Louisa and Uncle John. The newspapers were raving about a brand new plane that was premiering at our airport. My parents were supposed to fly on that plane. But they were late and their taxi got stuck in a traffic jam, so they missed their flight. I remember Dad got angry at Mom because she couldn't find her house key in her purse. They were only a few minutes late, but by the time they arrived at the gate, the plane was taking off. They could see it rising into the sky out the window. But then something horrible happened. Part of the plane exploded, the wings fell off, and then the plane broke in half, plummeting to the ground. My parents said when the explosion erupted, the windows rattled. Everyone stared out the window in shock, until someone panicked and people started screaming, abandoning their suitcases as they ran. The newspapers blamed the flight controller, until they discovered the airplane manufacturer had sold the defective airplane for big money. The investigation became so messy that my father decided to find out the truth about the plane crash. In the end, the court found the airline company liable for the crash. After all, the accident had claimed many lives. They interviewed my parents and took photos of them for the paper. I was very little then, but I still remember it. My parents tried to comfort the families who lost people on that flight. Part of the airport was destroyed, but a new business plan helped restore it.
I know you can do it, Auntie. Here, this is a photo of the plane that my parents were supposed to be on.
The Greys were too late at this point. They were frustrated as they watched their plane take off without them. If I could send a signal to the plane, I could stop it from taking off. I've got to find the flight control room.
Thank you.
some complications to your plan.
Thank you. did I do it? Have I really defeated fate itself?
At last I've won!
Jackie's parents are alive again. I've never seen her so happy. And I've never been so tired.